Opposition day number three, Mr. Klees.
Mr. Klees.
Thank you, Speaker.
You're from Newmarket, Aurora. I apologize.
Thank you. Speaker, I move that it is the will of the Legislative Assembly of Ontario that the McGuinty government call and appoint an all-party select committee to investigate and report on issues relating to Ontario's air ambulance system, including Orange and its affiliates, addressing specifically but not limited to issues of patient and employee safety, management, oversight, governance and accountability mechanisms, and that anyone called to testify or report before this select committee be afforded whistleblower protection.
Mr. Klees has moved opposition day number three. The member from Newmarket, Aurora.
Thank you, Speaker. Speaker, I want to begin this debate by setting out four goals that we hope to achieve through the establishment of the select committee being proposed by this motion and the hearings that will be conducted within the proposed terms of reference accompanying this motion. Our goals are as follows. First, to restore the confidence of the public, taxpayers and stakeholders and patients in Ontario's air ambulance service. Second, to ensure that the safety of citizens and patients is the first priority of the air ambulance network by installing professional, dedicated service providers and by returning primary oversight of the system of our air ambulance service to the Ministry of Health. Third, to address the problems created by the establishment of Orange and the related for-profit entities, and to ensure that a similar incident can never happen again in any ministry of the government. And fourth, to establish strict controls over the strategic direction and daily operations of air ambulance by centralizing command and control within the Ministry of Health, and to ensure effective oversight and accountability measures are in place. Now, Speaker, why is the establishment of a select committee so imperative to achieving these goals? Well, I think in order to answer that question, it's important to put into context the events that have led to the tabling of this motion. Concerns were first raised about what was going on at Orange more than a year ago. We heard from numerous past and current employees and contractors of service to Orange who provided information to us concerning questionable business practices that resulted in the leveraging of public health care dollars to spawn a complex web of private for-profit companies for the enrichment of a select few friends of the government. The standards and quality of service under the air ambulance services was progressively eroded, and patients, as a result, were put at risk. Now, Speaker, we brought these issues to the attention of the minister, did so repeatedly, and the minister claimed for the longest time that she knew nothing about it. Nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, the minister was questioned about Orange during hearings of the Standing Committee on Estimates on November 16th of 2010. The minister, the deputy minister, and the assistant deputy minister for direct services were questioned about the lack of salary disclosure, procurement policies, and the role of the for-profit companies. Most questions at that committee, Speaker, were left unanswered, with a commitment that these issues would be looked into. Well, apparently, they either weren't looked into, or if they were, nothing was done about it. The minister was again warned about the questionable business practices at Orange and the lack of accountability and the lack of oversight of this organization when I raised specific concerns on three separate occasions in the legislature on April 5th, April 13th, and again on the 21st of April. And rather than act on the information we provided, and the warnings that public health dollars were subsidizing the empire building that was going on under the cover of Ontario's public air ambulance services, the Premier, the Minister of Health, and the Minister of Finance insisted that Orange was in full compliance with its accountability agreement with the Ministry of Health. Nothing could be further from the truth. The fact is that stakeholders have made numerous attempts to alert the government to the fact that Orange was not meeting its obligations as set out in its agreement with the Ministry of Health. Those warnings were repeatedly ignored by this government. As early as July 2008, MPP Michael Gravel forwarded a letter of concern to the then Minister of Health, Kaplan, who dismissed his concerns by simply referring the complainant back to Orange itself. Contrary to the insistence of the Premier, the Minister of Finance, and the Minister of Health that all was well, the fact is that the government received numerous warnings that standards of service were being compromised and that public health care dollars were being leveraged to spawn a web of for-profit companies whose boards were populated with friends of the government and, quite frankly, people who should have known better than to allow the abuse of public dollars. In addition to ignoring our call for an investigation months ago, the government's successive ministers ignored letters from stakeholders who provided first-hand information about questionable business practices that were becoming common knowledge within the industry among stakeholders about Orange. Following the government's refusal to act on our concerns regarding Orange in April of last year, I met with the Auditor General, and I conveyed to him copies of the letters and emails and records of meetings with present and past employees and stakeholders and suppliers of Orange. I continued to pass along information as I received it, and we'll see the results of his findings when he files his report tomorrow. And Speaker, I'm confident that while the government may have ignored our warnings, it won't be able to ignore the report that the Auditor General will file tomorrow. One of the many warnings about Orange was contained in a letter sent to the Minister of Health on May 4, 2011, by the Ontario Air Transport Association. A five-page letter, Speaker, that speaks to the patient care that was being compromised, that speaks to many issues that were blatant in terms of transgression of the performance agreement that Orange had with the government. Suffice it to say that as we continued to receive information, we called on the Minister of Health to direct Orange not to proceed with any of its planned reorganizations that were underway, including waiting until at least the government received the report of the Auditor General. That request was also ignored by the government. And Speaker, that's why we're calling today for an all-party select committee to be struck by the government in cooperation with opposition parties so that we can get to the bottom of what has taken place. Speaker, this is not about simply wanting to look to the past. We must learn from the past, and the only way that we can do that is by ensuring that we provide a forum for current and past employees of Orange, who are professional men and women dedicated to providing important emergency health services to the people of our province, giving them a safe place to come to tell their story. Why is it important that these people come forward? Because they too will be able to provide us with advice in terms of how we can best restore confidence in our air ambulance service. I challenged the minister this morning during question period to be here to participate in this debate and to add her support to vote for the establishment of this committee. I reminded the minister that she herself, in question period on March 1st, made a very specific commitment that if in fact the legislature expresses its will to establish this select committee, that she would support that. I asked her to repeat that again, and unfortunately I sensed a backing off from that commitment. But we will be watching the debate, as are many people across this province. And Speaker, this is simply about ensuring that the important emergency air ambulance services of our province are restored to the point where patients can have confidence in the delivery of that service where the frontline paramedics and pilots and frontline dedicated dispatchers and administrators in that service can once again be proud that they represent the air ambulance service of our province. We are looking forward to move forward to restore that confidence. We need that select committee to ensure that the truth can be found out. We need to hear from frontline people without intimidation who have the protection of whistleblower protection so that they will not be retaliated against, so that we can once again celebrate the excellence of our air ambulance service in this province. Thank you, Speaker.
Further debate? The member for Newmarket Aurora.
Speaker, I want to thank my colleagues for participating in this debate. I want to thank my colleagues from the NDP caucus as well. I want to just say to you how disappointing it has been for me to hear members from the government caucus stand in their place and obviously tell us that they're going to be voting against this motion. And the reason I'm so disappointed is because I know that the people of this province are seeing once again a government that is intent on hiding the truth rather than having the truth come forward so that we can deal with it. The members of the government have spoken, each one who stood in their place, spoke about process and how everything is all right. Well, Speaker, we have heard that from this minister time and time again while a scandal was brewing all the time under her watch. We need the minister now to honor her commitment that she would support the will of the legislature, which will be determined by a vote in just a few minutes. We'll see what the integrity of the minister is all about in terms of how she responds to this vote. Thank you.
The ayes being 53, the nays are 41, I declare the motion carried.